Welcome to this video, where we will be looking at how to insert interactive elements into your publications. Calaméo automatically detects links already present in your original documents, but to modify them, add other links or interactive elements, use our editor. Click on your username to access the menu, and go to the Publications tab. Place your cursor over the publication you wish to add interactive elements to. Click on the arrow to display the menu and select Editor. This is our editor. On the left, you have icons corresponding to the different types of interactive elements you can add: external links, internal links, videos, music, images, and zooms. On the right, you have a navigation panel to easily go between the pages of your publication. With the icons at the bottom, you can change pages and adjust the zoom to work in more detail. Lastly, the Save button to save changes in your publication. To begin with, we're going to add an external link, which is a link to a web page of your choice. You can draw the zone for your link with your cursor directly on the page of your publication, or click on the external link icon. The blue zone represents your link. Move and adjust it until it covers the area of your link that you want. In the Link Properties window, here, you can change the type of interactive element for your zone at any time, with the icons across the top. Enter the URL for your link in the External Link field, making sure that it starts with HTTP or HTTPS. You can add a label for your link. This is the text that displays when you're passing your cursor over the link in your publication. If you want to insert an email address link, write mail to colon followed by the email address in the external link field. When a reader clicks on a mail to link, their webmail will open a new message to the recipient. Now we are going to create a link to a page within the publication. Go to the page on which you wish to insert the link and click on the icon Internal Link. Select the page number of the page you wish the link to redirect to. Here we want to send readers to the third page of the publication, so we will select page 3. This option is particularly useful if your publication includes a contents page. Your readers can then easily navigate to their pages of interest with internal links. With Calaméo, you can also insert videos in your publications. To do so, simply click on the video icon. We advise using videos in MP4 format. Your video files must be hosted online and available via a URL. It is not possible to add a video file from your computer. Enter the URL of your video while still making sure that it starts with HTTP or HTTPS. Only Platinum users can insert YouTube, Dailymotion, or Vimeo videos in their publications. Next, you can add audio to your publications by clicking on the music icon. It is possible to add an MP3 file if it's hosted online and available through a URL, although it's not possible to add audio files from your computer. Only Platinum users can add audio by adding SoundCloud links. It is also possible to add images to your publications with the editor. Lastly, we are going to see how to add an interactive zoom zone to your publication. Adding a zoom to an area of your page means that the selected area is enlarged when your readers click on it. It can be useful to create a zoom over an image or an area of text when the writing is small. Select the zoom factor you want, up to 5 times bigger. If you want to remove an interactive element, select it by clicking on it and press Delete on your keyboard. Remember to click Save before leaving the editor to save the modifications made to your publication. And now you're an expert in the use of the Calaméo editor. Now it's over to you. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to take a look at our other tutorials and see you soon on calaméo.com.